We're getting a bit old now, this is too high for me to climb up, but I've had to go all around and found that. Anyway, guys, it's wonderful to see everyone here today, all gathered at the protest against the experiments on animals. Absolutely wonderful. But in this event, this event has only taken place through the hard work of a few people that have organised it. So I want everyone to give them a round of applause. Now, my friends, we are living under a Nazi regime. And I'm not just talking about the Conservative government. I'm talking about the human species and the horrific regime we've imposed on the other animals. Not us stars here, of course, but the human species in general has opposed on the other animals in this world. That have been persecuted, abused, tortured, slaughtered by human imperialism. Now what we've got to remember is there's thousands of other animal species live on this earth. There's thousands of mammals, thousands of amphibians, fish, birds, reptiles. And there's one species of Nazi, the human species. And we've done to other animals, our species has done to other animals, exactly the same as the Nazis did to those they felt were inferior to them. And the other thing the Nazis did to those different races they thought were inferior to them was to do experiments on them. They did experiments with people of all races. And the big assessment today that doing experiments on innocent animals, they are no worse. They are no better. They're no better than the Nazis. And the attitude we should have to them is exactly the same. And we need to fight to stop them just as hard as people fought against the Nazis. Now, in the few years that the Nazis were in power, there were 6 million people died in the Holocaust. Now, what you've got to remember is the same number of animals die every 20 minutes in the world, in the Holocaust that the human species has imposed on other animals. Now, it's very important that people are vegan. I hope everyone's vegan here today. It's very important for animal liberationists to be vegan. But it's also really important that vegans campaign for animal liberation. Now, I think there's probably, perhaps 200-300 people here today on this march. It's marvellous that everyone's here. But back in the 70s and the 80s, on these events, there'd be thousands of people. I remember going on a march in the early 80s, where there were 10,000 people marching on World Day. Now, what's happened? Why has there been this decline in campaigning? In those days, there were a lot fewer vegans than we've got today. A lot fewer. Almost every vegan was a campaigner, or almost every vegan regarded himself as an animal liberationist. So there was loads of stuff going on. There's people doing direct action. There's people protesting. People doing leaf installs to educate people. All sorts of campaigning by vegans. Nowadays, we've got a load more vegans. Lots more in those days. But the problem is that hardly any of them get out as activists and get out as campaigners. And unfortunately, most of them would rather sit down eating cake and vegan burgers with their mates, share vegan recipes on Facebook, and get really excited about the latest vegan product in Morrison's. Now we've got a vegan festival just over there. Many of us would go in there after going around this march today. We deserve to go there and enjoy some vegan food. But how many of the vegans go to the festival today? Because there are a lot of vegans who will be going. I think the main aim of these festivals is not for vegans. I think the main aim of these festivals is to turn non-vegans into vegans. That's the main aim of them, not as a social event for vegans. But there'll be loads of vegans going to that festival today. They're not going to come here, not going to take part in this event to demonstrate against the restrictions. And I think that's bad. I think that's awful. And we have got to get it. Isn't it awful, eh? Come on, vegans, get off your arses. Get out and come play for the end. And that's going to change. Because if all the vegans was campaigned and you come out and we're ready, get active, whatever you can. Whatever you can, even if you're putting leaflets in letterboxes, getting out on the street, protesting, doing stores, whatever. Just think how far we've advanced in the GDL and my point to those people is get yourself active. Because the reason you're vegan in most cases is because you care about animals. So if you care about animals, I think you might. Cheers. It might be better if you can't hear me at all, actually. Is get out there. Because otherwise, we're not going to get animal liberation. But now in those days, back in the 70s, 80s, into the 90s, there was a whole wave of activism throughout the country. People doing direct action, people campaigning, protesting, people educating. And to a large extent now, that seems to have died away. And we need to revive that. We need a second wave. We need a second wave of activism.
Okay, right,
with everyone that cares about animals, everyone who's vegan, getting active. And getting out there. And if everyone does that, then you never know. We're going to make a big headway. We're going to move towards animal liberation.
We need money, basically.
And one thing I'd say to everyone here today is it's great. It's great everyone's out on this march, out on this demonstration. We've got to go far more than this if we're going to defeat the exception, if we're going to bring about animal liberation. Everyone's got to get active in their own area. And if you don't do so already, get active in your local animal rights group or vegan outreach group or whatever it's called. Get active, get out on the street, get out campaigning, get out educating, get out protesting. And if there isn't a group in your area, set one up. Because we can do this. You know, we're faced with an appalling tyranny. We're worst tyranny that ever happened. This appalling slaughter, abuse, torture of other animals. But if we do the right thing, if we become active, we can defeat this. If we can win, we can achieve animal liberation. So let's do it.